the magnetic induction due to a finite conductor. According to Ampere's law, due to infinite long conductor, it is mu naught by 2 pi into I by R. If I imagine conductor is infinitely long, the magnetic induction at L perpendicular distance or R perpendicular distance when current is I, B is given by mu naught by 2 pi into I by R. Now I am taking a finite conductor. So what is the magnetic induction due to a finite conductor? So imagine a conductor of length L. This is carrying I current. So what is the induction at a perpendicular distance R from the conductor? So imagine a point here. Let us say the two ends are making angles alpha and beta. Then induction at this point B is given by B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi I by R times sine alpha plus sine beta. This is the magnetic induction due to a finite conductor at a perpendicular distance R from the conductor. Here L, length of the conductor, is not present in the equation. Suppose if I imagine conductor is infinitely long, so extend it. So if I extend it, automatically alpha value increases. The maximum value for alpha is 90 degree, same as with beta. This is infinite. So if I substitute alpha and beta as 90 degree, then B becomes equal to mu naught by 4 pi into I by R times 2. So which is equal to mu naught by 2 pi into I by R. This is the induction due to an infinitely long conductor. So this is what we considered earlier. Now due to the finite conductor, the magnetic induction is always given by mu naught by 4 pi into I by R times sine alpha plus sine beta. Now suppose the magnetic induction due to a straight conductor, a finite conductor at R perpendicular distance is B. Let us say at this point the magnetic induction value is B. If the length of the conductor is increased, the induction at the same point. Is it just theory question? A finite conductor has induction capital B, current carrying conductor at R perpendicular distance, induction is B. Suppose if I increase the length of the conductor, then what about the B value? If I increase the length, in the equation there is no dependence on L. Length of the conductor is not at all involved. I by R into sine alpha plus sine beta. I is constant, R is constant, point is same, current is same. Only thing, I am increasing the length, though length is not involved directly, but it is involved indirectly in the form of alpha and beta. As the length of the conductor increases, alpha and beta increases. So as L increases, definitely B increases. Though L is not present directly, for a finite conductor, as the length increases, alpha and beta increases. That indicates the magnetic induction at that point automatically increases.